Hi guys, in this video I'm going to be reacting to a video titled Shane and Ryland, a literal scum of the earth. So let's begin.
Hey guys, so I'm like really, really trying to stay off social media best I can. I wasn't gonna post because I do feel like I'm in this state of shock and state of panic, state of disbelief, and just really trying to bite my tongue on so many things. But it's insane the more things that come out. So let me give you a little more background on my friendship with Shane Dawson.
So she's looking up constantly. Looking up is a sign that you're remembering something. Basically, in body language, we need to form a baseline. I know I've said this in every video, but it needs to be said. You look at someone's normal body language, and then you see the deviation from that normal body language during the time when they're presented with a stressor. So in this case, it's making this video, and maybe when she raises some points, remembering that acts as a stressor. So then you can read the body language she gives off after that. So I've already done a body language analysis of this YouTuber here. And yeah, she's got a normal baseline. She looks up when she's remembering. So yeah, that's a sign of honesty. When you look up, that's a sign that you're recalling something. Now, many people out there say that if you look to the left or if you're looking to the right, each side means that you're lying or telling the truth. That's nonsense. Everyone's baseline is different and you can't tell so much information just from one tell. You have to gather a whole group of tells, and that helps you then read the body language that they're giving off. So she's looking up. She's remembering stuff.
This is insane, and I'll tell. There's just like, how do I count the ways how insane this all is? So,
scratching at the back of the neck is a pacifying behavior. Basically, what a pacifying behavior is a way of the body calming its limbic system down. Limbic system basically means your brain that's not conscious. It's a part of your brain that deals with sort of the response that your body gives off. So when you get an itching feeling and you need to itch, that's the limbic system basically trying to calm you down. Scratching soothes your mind. It's a way of dealing with stress. It sounds silly, but it is. That's how it works. So scratching of the neck is a very strong tell that someone's in stress. Also, fidgeting, touching the nose, touching the face, jittery legs, shaking of the hands. That's all signs that someone's doing a pacifying behavior.
I started this morning with Ryland making his like statement on his podcast, to which he referred to me being like literally bullied. Like, I've never been bullied as an adult like this, unwarranted, on a trip where I was invited as like a friend and I was made fun of, told to jump off a ledge. Like, my sobriety was mocked. He told people that I wasn't, like, that I was on drugs. He told Oscar Wilde that I was on heroin. Crazy shit, obviously. Like, it wasn't like petty stuff is what I'm saying. Like, it's not petty. Like, he threw shit out. I spent thousands of dollars with that. Threw my shit out. Like, told people I was on drugs. Like, said there's a balcony jump when I was like, I'm suicidal. I was like, there's a balcony. Just do it. And they knew all this. They knew all this. And so Ryland.
Again, she continues to look up. She's being truthful. She's remembering events that actually happened. She's not making them up. If someone was making them up, you wouldn't expect to see them following their normal baseline of remembering. So she's looking up. That's what she does when she remembers. Other people do different things, look to the side, look down. She does look to the side in this a bit, but mainly up. So I would say that she's being truthful about that. But however, if she was looking down, if she was distancing herself from the camera, basically distancing is a way of the body putting something in front of the stressor. So for instance, leaning back, they're trying to get distance from the stressor. Looking away, they're trying to not maintain eye contact with the stressor. So if someone was making something up, you'd expect when they're lying to do that. And I've done other body language analysis videos. One of Richard Ramirez, the famous serial killer, the infamous serial killer, he is a perfect example of distancing. He looks away when he's saying points. He leans back. He's doing everything to distance himself from the situation. Whereas she's not. She's doing normal body language for remembering. So yeah, I'd say she's being very truthful currently.
Straight up just lied. Just so much bullshit on his podcast. I like can't breathe, sorry. So much bullshit on his podcast.
Pacifying behavior, she's fidgeting with her necklace. It shows she's stressed. It shows that her limbic system is basically trying to calm her down. She doesn't really think consciously, oh, I'm going to play with my necklace, or oh, I'm going to scratch my arms. That's not what we do. It's kind of subconscious. It just happens. We feel an urge to do it, and we just do it. It's a way of basically getting the mind to deal with the stress, because when you experience stress, you have to deal with it some way.
Saying, calling my this like really traumatizing thing in my life, trauma, says I never talked to them personally about it, which is such a lie on so many levels. My sister was there, like, right after that all happened, like, breaking down, crying. They're just liars. They both told me, like, oh my God, we're going to distance ourselves from Jeffrey. And Ryan's like, yeah, I never really liked Jeffrey. Like, he was always close to Shane. He never really talked to me. And Morgan, too. They're so fake. So fake. But to be like, I don't.
So she's being very honest there. Up to 60% of body language is communicated through the eyes. So that's where I look predominantly. And yeah, she's looking up. She's continuing to remember when she accuses them of being liars. If she was lying about that, you'd expect her to show some behaviors of a liar, or some behaviors that she may not be telling the truth. So she doesn't do any of those behaviors that anyone would consider to be lying. She doesn't distance herself. She doesn't maintain an excessive amount of eye contact or a little amount of eye contact. She doesn't do rapid head movements. She doesn't do rapid blinking. Although those two tells are actually signs of truthfulness as well, when coupled with other body language. So yeah, it's a sign of nervousness. So if your eyes are darting all over the place, if your head's moving all over the place, that can also be a sign that you're under a lot of stress. But if you couple those tells with then other tells, so distancing, that starts to build the picture that someone's a liar. But she's telling the truth here. She's looking up. She's remembering things. Her baseline doesn't change. She doesn't instantly try and distance herself when accusing someone of being a liar, which you'd expect someone to do. Or you'd at least expect their body language to change slightly. But hers doesn't.
I don't even know why Trisha's mad. I'm not mad at you. Like, you guys are supposed to be, like, the supposed my best friends. Like, never once. Oh, sorry. Like, hindsight, I'm, like, so stupid. I'm so stupid. When I think about this friendship, I'm so stupid. And I'm the one person, one of his friends, that, like, is so desperate. And I just wanted to, like, be liked by someone. And he would give me the validation in a way a toxic boyfriend would, right? Like, they string you along enough to, like, keep you happy and be like, hey, yes, I'm your friend, but also destroy you behind your back. And that's what I'm finding out now. Oh my God.
Rubbing of the head is a pacifying behavior. She's under a lot of stress and she's trying to deal with that stress by doing these pacifying behaviors. Very, very interesting to note. The most important things in body language are eye movements, pacifying behaviors, and distancing behaviors. If you can get them nailed, you can generally build a big picture as to what someone's thinking. The more in detail you go, such as, a mouth quiver or one tell, not a group of tells, it starts to get a bit, it's not as accurate to make a judgment, and only really experienced body language analysts can really sort of pick that apart and gauge something from it. It's very difficult. But yeah, from her tells, she's under a lot of stress. She's been truthful in what she's remembering. She hasn't tried to distance herself, so it seems like she's comfortable talking about it. She's comfortable accusing people of being liars, which indicates truthfulness. So yeah, all these tells suggest someone is being truthful. There's nothing there that makes me go, oh, but she did that, so maybe it's not true. Because I've done other videos in the past where they've done body language that may not match what they should be displaying, and that's something to note. But again, people make stuff up all the time. People lie, even about the smallest things. So even if they do lie once, it doesn't mean everything that they've said is a lie, basically.
Crazy. Like, I did all my TikToks on Ryland, just like the straight up lies he told. Like, I'm still so shook. He's like, we could have talked this out. Literally made me, like, it was, everything was wrong with me. Never took one out, like, never once gave me any credit. Like, yeah, Trish did talk to us about this. It's crazy. He just totally skimmed over Jeffrey. Once again, Jeffrey just coming out of the scotch clean, because, everyone's throwing the blame on Jay. And, like, yeah, Jay was stupid enough to air it out, but who do you think talked like that? Who do you think, that's what the Vegas trip thing was all about. Jay just confirmed it. And they knew about it. They knew about it so much. I have so many text messages I could show. Like, Shane and Jeffrey do everything in voice memo. But you can see my side of the text where I'm like breaking down everything that happened, and Jeffrey's like apologizing. And then I'm changing it to Shane, and he's like, obviously, you can't see because of the fact. I'm having some sort of like acid reflux or something. I don't know what's happening. My sister was there. It's really, really insane. But then you start thinking, like, oh my God, I was just so desperate. Never once did they, like, I think about, like, my tours and stuff. I had a show in Anaheim, my first show, well before Shane, like, hit with the series, the docuseries. Gigi came, like, all my YouTube friends came. I had one in LA, like, a year and a half ago, and he couldn't even come to that. And that was the same month that his conspiracy pile came up, where he put a shadow named after me in it. And I guess that was supposed to be, like, some big honor. And, like, now I'm thinking, like, Yeah, he didn't even go to my show. Anyways, just shitty, shitty friends. And over the years, he's always, like, fed me stuff.
Rapid blinking there, and also sign of aggression when she, literally just as I paused it, her face gets more aggressive. She's angered by it, but also then she's very stressed and upset by it. So basically, if someone's lying, they tend to form a image of how they should present themselves, and then they just present themselves as that. Whereas she is going through emotions. So she's changing her body language. She's deviating from her baseline. So you see that she was getting aggressive when she was remembering something. If someone was lying, they'd maintain the same body language throughout. And it's always wrong. You can always tell it's not true, because not everyone studied body language. And even then, even if you maintain a consistent body language and you do everything you can to maintain that, you only have to slip up once. And because it's your subconscious, your body reacting to things, you can't fake that consistently for a long period of time. And it only takes one tell for someone like me to go, that shouldn't be there. Why is that there? And then expanding on that. So yeah, very difficult to fake your body language. It's a very strong sign that she's being truthful, showing that she's going through a lot of emotions there. The rapid blinking also shows that she's very anxious. She's very sort of just stressed by it. Her whole limbic system is stressed. She's frustrated. And then when she remembers that thing about her friend and she gets angry by it, that shows genuine emotion, because people who lie don't go through different emotions constantly. They can keep the same lies and the same attitude to those lies throughout, whereas she is all over the place. I say this in every video that I make. If someone's all over the place, it's a very good sign, because it shows that they're going through so many emotions and they're letting their mind pull them through those emotions, which is very genuine, authentic. It's difficult to fake.
Right? Like, he's always fed me things, like, stuff that I wouldn't know or care about, but gets me, like, riled up. Like, for instance, stuff he said about Garrett and Drew and, like, Andrew. Like, I don't know any of them. But guess what? Like, as soon as they became a group, remember when they were all a group? I was tossed to the side. When, like, Garrett, Rylan, Morgan, Drew and him were, like, and Andrew were all making, like, you know, haunted videos. I was tossed to the side. Like, whatever. I'm only around when, like, Shane falls. And, like, he's always feeding me stuff because he knows I have a loud mouth and he knows I get riled up. And sometimes he'll even say, like, oh, I shouldn't say this. I don't want to, like, trigger you, or, like, I don't know. Like, I remember during my David stuff, he would, like, feed me stuff about David from, like, podcast clips of him being, like, a sociopath. And, like, I never used this stuff because I didn't really know.
Look at the distance she is from the camera. She goes from being further back, which is distancing, to being closer to the camera. So the fact that she shifts through them shows that she's going, again, through different emotions. When she comes close to the camera, she's on the attack. She's confident. She's trying to make a point. She's trying to get the audience to listen to her. She's confident in that. That's a sign of confidence. You wouldn't go up to a stressor, or in the caveman times, you wouldn't go up to a tiger. You'd try and keep your distance. But she's confident. She feels she can get this. So she leans in. She puts her body in distress, basically. It's think of evolution. All of our body language comes from that. We have a stressor, and we need our brain to determine whether that stressor is going to kill us or not. If you see a very, I don't know, someone who looks very dodgy, very, very mysterious in a bad way, your body naturally tries to keep you away from that. You don't go right up to it. No one does that. And if you tried, you'd feel very uncomfortable. But the fact that she's leaning into it, she's willing to take on that stressor, which shows she's confident. She's very confident with this. If you take anything from this, take that she's going through a lot of emotions. She's remembering a lot of factual things, because she's doing the tales of someone who's remembering stuff. She's very upset by it because she's going through a lot of pacifying behaviors, but she's not lying. She's not doing any distancing behaviors. In fact, she's so confident in what she's saying, she's going closer to the camera. She's addressing the stressor. So, yeah, I say very truthful.
He's like, oh, well, like not knowing there was an issue. So many people are like, oh, well, like my issue, and I told Shane when he did contact me on Saturday, only he only contacted me after I started mentioning him and Rylan on TikTok. He did not call me after my initial J video that I was like upset and distraught about. He didn't care. He didn't give a fuck about just checking on me. Then he cared after I started mentioning Shane and Rylan on the TikToks. And then the next day, he's like, I can't sleep. Like my anxiety, like just started really like manipulating me again and be like, I love you. I'm going through therapy. And when I told him my issues, which was like them like praising Jeffrey, him lying about his friendship with Jeffrey last year, and all of a sudden now he's like, he was the only one that was there for me. Of course, he was the only one that was there for you. You both did really messed up shit. Honestly, really messed up shit. Like, cancel me for thinking I'm a different gender or whatever, but they did some nasty, nasty ass shit, okay? Half the stuff I didn't even know about. I ended up watching D'Angelo Wallace's video and I had never seen it before. And honestly, like, I'm not trying to like go back to that, but like some nasty shit. But here's some nasty shit. So everyone's like, oh, like, how could you ask him to delete that podcast? Or Ryan's like, I don't know, I don't know. Like, F you, you didn't. Shane has had me take down multiple videos. There was one with Trevor Moran. Like, that's the only one that's still private for me, is the one with Trevor. And he's like, I'm sorry, Chevy is his is her name. So sorry, I'm so sorry. Like, I honestly, oh, sorry, I'm trying not to edit this. But at the time, well, it was Chevy.
More pacifying behaviors, more leaning into the camera, getting closer to the stressor, addressing key points. So, yeah, just if you want to study body language, just learn about pacifying behaviors because she does them a lot in this video. Learn about distancing behaviors because, yeah, that's what liars do. This isn't the best video for it because I think she's telling the truth, but I've done videos on liars before, so go watch them. They're really informative. And yeah, just if you look at how fast she speaks as well. When people lie, they think about their lies. It's very difficult to speed up how much you lie because if you're pumping out information very, very quickly, that's difficult to fake. Now, liars will explain things in more detail to try and make it believable that they'll overcompensate. They'll put so much information into it. But that's not what I'm talking about here. What I'm talking about here is the speed of which it's said. She is going through so much information very, very quickly. She talks about so much stuff quickly, and it looks terrible. It sounds terrible, honestly. But that's good because it shows that she's being genuine. She's spilling everything out there. Liars wouldn't do that. Liars would be thoughtful about it because they don't want to get caught out. She's just like, bugger that. I'm going to say everything because she's telling the truth. Again, it's part of the, if it looks unplanned, if it looks terrible, it's probably true. That's what it usually is. Liars tend to make themselves look like they're being truthful by being organized, collected, and it just doesn't work. I mean, if you look at Amber Heard, for instance, she's sitting there in the video that I analyzed. She's just not giving off any cues. She's just sort of sitting there delivering what she's planned in her head, and that's it. There's no emotion, there's no speed at which she says stuff. There's no, it just looks too planned. This looks terrible. In the videos that she did before, it looks even worse. She's crying, she's her face is red, it's terrible. But it means that she's being truthful because she's going through such emotions. It's difficult to fake that. Really difficult.
Age, and it was like, and I just blindly deleted it, and I'm so stupid. Like I didn't think anything of it because I was like, oh, there's like nothing bad in it or whatever like that. And it's like, I'm so freaking stupid. But yeah, you're getting canceled for kissing minors and making those jokes. Like that's okay. That's like a different level. Jeffrey was getting canceled for saying he was for aggressively saying racial slurs, saying he's gonna throw acid on people's faces, spitting on people. These are some real life shit that they're doing like off camera behind closed doors. Okay, cancel me because I'm a troll or whatever. I don't like. Okay, fine. Like I just and you know what? I own up to it. And that's what's so freaking crazy is Ryland.
Notice there how she thinks about something and then her whole body shifts, her baseline shifts, she gets enraged by it. And that's good because that shows that she's being genuine. If you planned this, you tried to lie. Again, it's very difficult to lie in a 40-minute video. That's just I think it's impossible personally, unless you're like the best actor in the world. But even then you'd need to plan it for hours and hours and hours. But the fact that she just is all over the place, she's going from trying to be calm and then remembering something that basically annoys her very much, And then she goes right into it with the aggression. That's good. That shows that she's going through genuine emotions. It's not fake. It's not scripted. It's not planned. So yeah, if someone said to me that she's faking it, I'd say she's probably one of the best actors on the planet.
Just putting all the blame on me. Well, I don't think she could express herself right when she's talking about Jeff. It couldn't have been more clear. And you know it. It's crazy. Like, it's so scary. And he's just, like, dead behind. It's, like, literally dead and cold behind his eyes. I look at that and I was just like, sold their soul to the devil. And that's why I want no part of it. No part of them. Like, rebuke it. It's, whew. So then I see this Reddit. Someone sent me of Peter Mon from last year, last September, doing a video. Sorry, I'm like, oh, I'm gonna like pass out. Basically, he made a video in response to something I said, like, I don't know, probably defending Shane or something, I don't know. And me and Peter Mon actually have a really bad history because he's another one who's accused me of being a liar. And kind of makes sense why he would think that. I was reading on like Reddit, I think someone sent me it was, and someone's like, you know, Trisha's like never really lied, because you know what, when I do, like, when I like talk about my experiences with people like David Dobrik, you know, Jason, whoever, like, I'm someone who's not gonna like lie on shit because it's easily provable or unprovable. I'm not gonna like risk my reputation, my being sued, all that stuff like that. Like, I'm actually really cautious about what I say because of that.
Another thing actually that's really cool to look at is when people feel ashamed of themselves. So in the mini light apology that I did and the power of cynical response, yeah, those two videos, they look down. Looking down is a strong sign that you feel bad about what's happened, you feel ashamed about what's happened. Not necessarily that you're guilty, but that you feel like what you've done, or you feel sorry for yourself. Basically, it's feeling sorry for yourself, but it's, you know, that can be justified if you're in a difficult situation. Of course, you'll feel sorry for yourself. But she doesn't do that, which is, it doesn't say whether she's lying or not at all, but it's a cool thing to note. She's confident in herself. She has a lot of self-confidence. We can give her credit for that because she doesn't, all these people seem to have turned on her, or she believes that they've turned on her. I'm not here to comment on drama. I don't do that, really. But she's confident. She's annoyed that they're doing all this to her. Of course, she's upset by that, but she knows she's in the right, and she's not ashamed of that, and she's fighting it, and that's why she's releasing these videos, which is really respectable, I think.
Like, there's so much more I could say, and then I'm just like, do I remember that right? Do you know what I mean? And I've always had to make a conscious effort of that forever. So me and Peter have this, like, history just to whatever, be like, we just don't really like each other. I don't really care for him because he like said I was lying about an opioid addiction. Like, it's like, I share so much, and I think like people are just like not used to people sharing so much, and I get that, but I'm gonna keep.
So I think I'm gonna call that a day there. I've seen enough of the video to get the impressions that I've got from her. She's being very truthful. She's clearly affected deeply by these events. She's upset by them naturally. And yeah, but completely truthful. You can tell that by the fact that she looks like she's remembering things. She's doing the tales of someone who's remembering factual events that they've witnessed. So yeah, there's that firstly, but that alone isn't enough to tell if someone's being a liar or not. But then also what she does, well, it's what she doesn't do. She doesn't do any of the tales of a liar. So she doesn't try and distance herself, which is what you'd expect from liars. And we've seen that in the videos that I've analyzed before. She does all the body language of someone who's telling the truth. And you can match that up. And this video is a long video. And the video I've seen before of her, she does the exact same thing. She's maintaining her baseline, which is someone who's upset. She's doing all the tells that she was doing before. She doesn't change those tells. She just does them more or less. The only thing she does change is the voice and the aggression. But that's understandable because, and that actually proves, or well, doesn't prove, but supports the fact that she's telling the truth, because she's going through such emotions. And I said it in this video, if someone's all over the place, it's mostly that they're going to be truthful, because liars don't plan to change their emotions like that, and they wouldn't know what body language to do consciously, because it would have to be conscious because they're not feeling it. They wouldn't know what body language to do. And even if they did, it would look bad because they don't know every single tell. And then even if they did make it look convincing, all it takes is one body language cue for me to point that out and go, that shouldn't be there. So it is very difficult to fake. So yeah, she's being truthful. I know she's being truthful. 99% sure. There is always a 1% that someone's a master liar and is trained and has done this video a million times to perfect it. But yeah, she is telling the truth, and she was telling the truth in the last video. And if she does any more videos, I'd expect the same body language. If this drama does move forward and she makes up stuff to create more drama, deliberately she lies, we'll be able to pick up on it. So yeah, if you enjoyed the video, please be sure to hit that like button and subscribe, because it really does help the channel out. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, guys. See you in the next video.